Do you ever get this? Do you yodel?
I have not done the like traditional yodel.
Oh, she told me to yodel.
Always been a little bit of something in my voice that I have noticed. I think maybe from people kind of pointing out that I do have a little bit of that comes out. And I have noticed and I've heard a little bit of the yodel. I have not really done the traditional yodel. I think it'd be really fun to try. Definitely need some practicing on that.
Born in a land by the railroad track where the river soaks you through and there's no way back. You offer me your hand smoking big cigars while you're singing for your supper in a beat up bar. And his love rides the truck stops home.
This we got Sabrina Lentini all the way from SoCal, Southern California, the beaches of California, Orange County. How are you doing today, Sabrina?
I'm doing great. Thank you so much for having me. How are you?
we are good. We're so good. We're so happy that you're joining us in our new season 5 with us, Bandwagon TV's Joyride. So we're very excited to have you. Not only that, we know you have a new single. So we cannot wait to promote that, but we want to get to know you a little bit. You know, West Coast woman playing country music, and I know you've been making it out to the Nashville scene. If you don't mind, tell us a little bit about yourself, your musical background.
Music has seriously been my whole life, and ever since I was little, I've been singing nonstop. There's always been music in the house, whether, you know, on my grandparents' jukebox, or at my house with my parents, or in the car, like car rides with my dad. And just over the years, I've listened to anything and everything, and I love it all. And it's really the storytelling that country music has that just called my heart. And as my music has evolved throughout the years, that is where my heart has landed in my sound.
You have a really unique sound. I have a question for later. So I don't know if I want to spoil it, but is that your family's a bunch? I mean, so your musical background, you have a bunch of musicians in the family?
There are musicians on both sides of my family, actually. So music does somehow run in our blood on both sides. There's beautiful singers. My cousins on my mom's side and also on my dad's side. My dad grew up playing guitar, and he would play guitar to my mom's belly when I was, you know, in there. And that's really a sweet story that he tells about, like, when I was really little, like one of the first times, like, he was alone with me at the house and he was watching a football game, and during the commercial he turned it off and he just started strumming the guitar, and I guess my head like turned around at him. And yeah, just music was always around, musicians on both sides of the family, and just beautiful voices.
Like we usually do, we stalk our musicians. And I can tell, and nothing like creepy, just we want to get to know you, and especially because we love everyone has a great story and we just can't wait to share it. So what we typically do is, you know, we're just looking around, and what I wanted to ask was, your parents look like they're such a huge part of your one success, but also being a musician, your musical career. How is it having their support?
Already I'm like gonna cry. Gosh, I don't know what I would do without them. They have, of course, they've been with me from, you know, day one as a human being, but especially every step of the way with my music. Every show throughout the years from age 5 to now, they are there with me. Like, especially here in California, they come to every show with me. They are just always there, always been so supportive, and they are my biggest cheerleaders and my best friends, and I'm just so lucky.
No, you are. They look like two fantastic, just great people, and especially to help you. And I know that, and this is my next question, making the move, you know, going from the Southern California, and then going to Nashville, how is that on you, but also on them and your family?
My first couple trips out there, they came with me, and it was really wonderful because you realize how quickly, especially in music, but how small a world it really is. And running into people I know there from here and vice versa happens all the time and more, especially, you know, throughout the years of traveling there more and more. And so those first few trips with them, oh, they were, you know, just so cool and so special. I really realized how much I love Nashville and how it really is a home away from home for me. And it was so cool because the first time I went, they got to like experience with me. I played in the round at the Bluebird Cafe. And that was so magical and just an incredible experience. And having them be there that time and also for my other trips or flying to me or driving to me to take the road trip back, it's just been so much fun. But being there alone has really been my first times being off alone anywhere, if that makes sense. Because like,
yeah.
I never went off to a campus for college or any of that. So going to Nashville was, you know, me kind of spreading my wings on my own. And of course, I call them like 1,000 times a day, 1,000 times, every little thing. But, you know, again, it is my home away from home. And I just really love being there. And there are definitely so many parts of it. When I'm here in California, I miss Nashville. And when I'm there, I miss here. And yeah. It really is the best of both worlds. And it kind of like Hannah Montana, we all joke about it, but it really is like such a true saying. And I love both places so much.
Very lucky. And, you know, we got a lot of questions that are geared towards this, but I wanted to say it's just a great trip to watch you back and forth making that bounce. And I can only imagine how fun that is. But Sabrina, we thank you, but now we have to pull over the white lightning, which means the lightning round is upon us. So, so strap in. It might get a little rough, but I promise it'll be a lot of fun. Okay, so let's pull over the white lightning. And while we do, while we do this virtually, so today we wanted to promote our local business. It's called Folicious or Folicious.net or Folicious Kits. You can catch them on Amazon. They're a great a small business. It's a wife and husband, Ann and Joseph, here locally here at in our hometown of Lampasas. And I don't know if Sabrina, if you're familiar or have had pho, it's delicious here. Vietnamese dish. It's very good. And what you can do is you can order these bowls that come basically, all you do is you need to add water and you can order them on Amazon. They on their social media, it's at Folicious Kits. And then online on their website, it's folicious.net. So definitely go check them out. They're a great couple. They're doing a lot with the community. And I think it's a great idea. They were just featured on QVC. So they got lots going on. Oh, also, their peanut sauce. Peanut sauce is delicious. And I think you can be able to find that online soon. So definitely make sure to catch that. Okay, here we go. Lightning round. We have Sabrina Lentini with us. And I promise it's not going to be too tough, but it's going to be a lot of fun. So here we go. All right. Starting off a little on the hard question here. Where would you rather be right now? The beaches of California or Music Row?
Gosh, why'd you have to do that to me?
I had to throw you off.
Well, I'm a big believer in where you are right now is exactly where you're meant to be. So I'm going to stay here at home with my family. But of course, I'm always missing.
What's the weather like right now? What are we looking at?
It is hot today. It is like, I think it's 90s now, it's 90s, so it's already feeling like summer, and it's crazy because just a few weeks ago, I was in Nashville and it snowed.
Those are extremes.
Yeah, absolutely.
I can't help but notice, and I love asking fashion-oriented questions, okay? So, I have to ask, what's more country to you, a cowboy hat or those bell-bottom jeans?
Well, I would say my style is the bell-bottom jeans because I've been wearing those since I was like 14 years old, and those are just the most comfy me jeans that I love. But I did recently just get a Stetson hat that I love, so My gut is the bell bottom jeans for sure.
Well, good answer. You look great. Love bell bottom jeans. I think I need a pair.
Oh yeah, everybody should have.
They're definitely good. They're in right now. Okay. Can't help but notice you play the guitar, but now you're on stage. You need another instrument with you, okay? What, which one is it gonna be? Is it gonna be a fiddle, the steel guitar, or a standing piano?
For me or for someone else to play?
For someone else to play.
Pedal steel.
Yes, love it, I love that twang. We're getting a lot of that, so I wanna keep the momentum going here with that. I wanted to bring this up just really quickly. You've really, in terms of your career, it's gone, I think you have a great voice, and I wanted to ask regarding do you ever get this? Do you yodel? I didn't catch anything, but have you ever yodeled before?
I have not done the like traditional yodel. I think there's always been a little bit of something in my voice that I have noticed. I think maybe from people kind of pointing out that I do have a little bit of that comes out, like
yeah,
notes, or like what I like to call, and I think every musician sort of has their own like, or singer knows of their own sweet spot in their range that they like, or you know what I mean, like where they kind of feel like, I don't know, that they know is one of their, I guess, characteristics, like, so great that or naturally incorporate that in their music. And I have noticed, and I've heard a little bit of the yodel. I have not really done the traditional yodel like full out. I think it'd be really fun to try. I would definitely need some practicing on that.
Well, I thought maybe you do. You have a great sound. The music is just, I love listening to it. But I wanted to ask you, this new single that we're about to promote, you really, I think we're focusing too on the lyrics. So I wanted to ask you, what's more important to you right now, the music or the lyrics?
Lyrics. I'm definitely the type of listener where if I hear a song that just immediately grabs me, you know, whether on the radio or it's, you know, an artist that I love, I just have to grab my phone and look up the lyrics at the same time, or close my eyes and visualize those lyrics, because it really truly is about the storytelling. For me, that's what I really love. And of course, when it has that drive to a song and those melodies and the harmonies, when it makes the whole experience come together, it's such a beautiful thing. And I really do think it stems though from the lyrics. I'm just really big on on the words and just really good internal rhymes and things that may surprise you. And
no, I can see it. You're really evolving in terms of just being an all-around musician, and I wanted to tell you that I noticed that, and it's fantastic. We're very excited for you. But here we go. This is the last one. You're doing great. We need to know. You've taken over. You're in the driver's seat of the White Lightning. You're going from West Coast to East Coast, back to Nashville. You need a co-pilot, musician, dead or alive. Who do you got?
If I could have the whole ABBA band in the 100%, because their music is like my happy music. And again, their harmonies, their stories, and those melodies are just, they create such an immersive experience for me that if I could have that constantly just in my ears, I would be very happy.
Okay, so now you have the whole crew. So it's a very crowded truck. Maybe the guys are in the back. You need to play a song for them. Are you playing one of your own? Or are you playing one of their popular songs? Maybe a deep cut no one really knows about but you and them? What do you got?
If it were one of my own, I would choose my song Grow. I would love to hear the harmonies, and like what I love is how they do the call and answer in kind of their backup vocals as well. So yeah. If I do that, but my go-to of their songs would be Take a Chance on Me.
Yes, I was hoping you were gonna say that. Take a chance, take a chance, take a
that
chance.
Good. Totally how I felt before. So.
Oh, see, we are right now. We are connected, because I was the whole time saying, please say she takes a chance. Okay. We love it. We love when we get those great answers. Thank you so much for having so much fun with us. Sabrina, you did great, but now this is on you. So we wanted to promote your new music, your new single, Everything But You. It's definitely become one of my favorites. And like I said, you have this beautiful voice with great lyrics. I know that it's just been released, but what do we have more to expect from you this year?
Thank you so much. That really, really just means so much. So thank you. So Everything But You is obviously out now, and I'm just so excited for hopefully, you know, as many people to hear it as possible. I really, really have so many fun ideas for visuals for this song. So hopefully a music video in the very, very near future, and just more releases of songs that are both brand new and also ones that I've been holding on to for a little while now that I've been dying to release. So lots more new music. I sometimes forget how to speak, but lots of new songs, and also, of course, you know, performing, which I love so much, and getting to meet new people at my shows and see the familiar faces, and so I hope to see some of you at some shows.
It's okay if you forget how to speak, just don't forget how to sing, because we just need that voice.
Thank you.
All right. Well, Sabrina, this is now on you. We want to get, how do we find you? How do we listen to you on all platforms?
I am on all music platforms at Sabrina Lentini, and that is Lentini, as in very Italian, and Sabrina as in the teenage witch. I always figured that helps a little bit. But yes, all of my recent releases on iTunes, Apple Music, Spotify, Amazon, wherever you listen, and every stream means the world, and every share add to your playlist. It seriously means so much. And also social media is at Sabrina Lentini on Instagram, and on Facebook, it's facebook.com/officialSabrinaLentini.
And definitely go subscribe, YouTube, all this is very important. Sabrina, thank you so much for joining us. And we can't wait for you this year. I feel like it's going to be a really exciting year for you.
Thank you so much. It's so wonderful talking with you. Thank you for having me.
Of course. Well, unfortunately, we got to kick you out. I love SoCal. I love me some, but it's a bit too hot. So I got to get back. All right. But before we leave you to the curb, before we kick you out, we need a song. We just need one song. What song do you want to play for us today?
Well, how about the new single, Everything But You?
Oh, see, we're connected. I was hoping for that. Well, there you go. There is Sabrina Lentini, Everything But You.
I don't want to give it all away. So here's just a little snippet of Everything But You. I've seen 100 cars that look like yours driving by. Bandwagon TV for having me.
There you go. There's Sabrina Lentini with Everything But You. Like I said, it's one of my favorites, so now it's one of yours. It's, I think, mandatory. So thank you so much, Sabrina, for sharing.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Hey, you're welcome. Well, before we let you go, so are we going to see you in Nashville soon? What's going on, like, in terms of your summer?
I will definitely be back for the summertime when it'll be nice and hot and humid there. I'll be bringing the California heat. And hopefully, again, also in the springtime, late springtime, but definitely the summer. Like, I'm thinking June, July, I'll see you there.
Well, we'll follow you on your social media. And, you know, we're also in Texas, so don't be a stranger. You can always visit us down in Austin.
Oh my gosh, I love Austin. I definitely hope to visit you there.
Well, we look forward to seeing you. I forgot to ask, are your parents, are they from Italy, or are they, because I wanted to say ciao.
They are not. They're both from California, but it's on, you know, my father's side.
Yeah, strong Italian roots.
Yes.
Ciao, Sabrina. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Well, darling. Thank you.
I want to take you home.